later. This poem is called Deceived for Loretta. She was a wife in Brooklyn, a mother of four, in her grandmother's brownstone on the top floor. She was a young 34, 25 years ago, a healthy, young, strong, always with a glow. Her husband, good looking, same age as his wife. Construction was just a part of his life. He always hung in the streets, drank with buddies on the block. He filled his days jiving with his flock. She planned family barbecues, block parties too, coordinated neighborhood birthdays, cooked the winter stew. She was life on top of life, steady in her game. People tried to be like her, wanted some of her fame. Separated from her husband, tired of the ship that had gone down, he said, "Baby, please don't make our life a ghost town." She had given him many chances, she always took him back. She didn't see a reason that time to bend or slack. We hoped she would keep her word, never let him back in. For that one night he asked with that salacious grin. She loved her husband true, and they shared many beautiful years. But three things grew ugly with so many tears. They argued about little things, compatible no more. Being with each other had become such a chore. But still the question arose, would he charm himself back in? Would he flavor all those adjectives to continue his sin? Mr. Man was doing drugs, his wife sang the blues. She had hoped that he would stop, didn't want any bad news. He no longer made her toes curl, no more taking care of the kids. Not the man he was so suave, his role was on new bids. He knocked, she opened the door, and how they won't forget, the dinner table was so pretty, it was all set. A couple of weeks had passed, not together with her man. Something with her wasn't right, that is never in a plan. Her balance wasn't steady. She had shortness of breath. Ran a slight fever, just didn't feel at her best. Back and forth to the hospital, doctors couldn't guess. How'd she been full of life before this sudden distress? Sent home many times for weeks, her strong body grew weak and frail, her husband tried to pamper, but to no lasting avail. Admitted to the hospital, then back and forth home, we all sat so uneasy and listened to her moans. The morphine helped somewhat to calm and mostly eased her pain. Her sister couldn't stand to hear how she wheezed her name. Her vision had gotten hazy, her skin flaky and dark. Her fingernails turned yellow as her babies played in the park. Her lungs had problems functioning without any oxygen tank. The tracheotomy so uncomfortable, she lay her mind and gone in a blank. A serum from Africa arrived, a last resort. It was how she handled her battle, a soldier on the fort. Whispers of what she may have had, morphine steadily upped. What had happened to her sister, it all seemed so abrupt. Her husband sat by her side, wondered how and what. But then he ran himself ragged, what about all his cuts? She had lost weight, body always hot, not much appetite anymore, and she cried an awful lot. She told her sister, I'm scared. Demons have come to tease. Her sister told her clearly, the Lord will put you at ease. Then the call when the family was home, patient, not feeling, not pulling through. Come quickly as you can and expect no good news. She passed on before they got there, husband at her side. No one knew the answer, only guesses why. About 5 years later, sister saw the news, a few documentaries that gave her some clues. Loretta died of AIDS. Seems her husband was slick. He was the carrier while he messed with chicks. He killed 4 women with it. Eventually, he knew he had. He died 10 years later, and yes, we were all glad. The only regret her sister had was that she died not knowing. But why her sister would be glad is that her children and their children are healthy and growing. Thank you.